Recently, we have seen many developments in space technologies, mostly from SpaceX. But other companies are also trying to compete in space, and one of them is Jeff Bezos' Blue Origin. While we often heard about SpaceX missions and launches over the past few years, Blue Origin does not come out to be so ambitious in gaining traction. In the last 2 years alone, SpaceX has performed 21 launches, representing about 20% of roughly 100 worldwide launches. So where does Blue Origin stand? What's their current progress in the rocket industry? Let us discuss the differences between Blue Origin and SpaceX in today's video of DiscoverZen. The space projects have been dominated by government bodies until we saw the ambitious companies such as SpaceX and Blue Origins diving into this diverse area. These two are the most prominent names in the private space community and are often put on a face-off due to the similarities of its founders and as well as other areas. Owned by two of the most powerful businessmen of all time, Elon Musk and Jeff Bezos, they have been on the competition radar for their interest in the areas of autonomous vehicles. While two companies might look quite similar in their attempts to explore space, the ideology and the approach of these companies vary significantly. But one thing cannot be denied, that they both have very ambitious goals and are developing large, reusable vehicles capable of carrying people and satellites across space. Blue Origin LLC is an American privately funded aerospace manufacturer and suborbital spaceflight services company headquartered in Kent, Washington. Founded in 2000 by Jeff Bezos, the company is led by CEO Bob Smith and aims to make access to space cheaper and more reliable through reusable launch vehicles. But their long-term plans are very, very different compared to SpaceX. They want to create the infrastructure and enable future generations to build O'Neill cylinders, which are large habitats designed to spin to replicate Earth's gravity for long-term residents and onboard agriculture. Jeff Bezos, in a presentation, detailed his dreams to put up to 1 trillion people in space in these O'Neill colonies. But this, of course, won't happen soon enough for the current generation of humans to move around in a floating space colonies, but it's supposed to be the start of a very ambitious goal for humans to live somewhere which will be artificially created. Its ambitions are not too different from SpaceX. Its rocket called New Glenn is often the talk of the town, and the company is aiming to launch it in 2021. This rocket will be powered by an engine developed by the company itself, called the BE-4. It was secretly founded in 2000 by Bezos, but has only gained attention after 2015. It is also working on a new Shepard. It's a vertical takeoff and vertical landing rocket that the company wants to use for human tourism. In 2018, SpaceX sent an AI-based robot called Simon, short for Crew Interactive Mobile Companion, to the International Space Station. It was designed to help astronauts perform their work such as scientific experiments. It became the first AI technology to be launched to the space station. Not just that, the recently launched Falcon 9 rocket also made use of the artificial intelligence. It has a sophisticated AI autopilot that steers the cone-shaped Crew Dragon. Once it reaches within 60 feet of the space station, the astronauts maneuver it. Talking about Blue Origin, Bezos' parent company, Amazon Cloud Unit, AWS recently unveiled a new space business segment called Aerospace and Satellite Solutions Business Segment. With an aim to bring AWS services to the space enterprises and the satellite industry, it aims to help them with the spaceflight operations. It aims to reimagine space system architectures, launch services that process space data on Earth, provide secure, flexible, scalable, and cost-efficient cloud solutions to space missions. It might hardly come as a surprise if Blue Origin tries to benefit from it in the coming future. Now, let's look at some of the rockets by Blue Origin and compare them to SpaceX. Named after Mercury astronaut Alan Shepard, the first American to go to space, New Shepard is the company's reusable suborbital rocket system designed to take astronauts and research payloads past the internationally recognized boundary of space. Whether you are an astronaut flying with Blue Origin or sending a payload to space, the trip will not take more than 11 minutes for you to get there. The new Shepard rocket is a relatively small rocket, coming in at just 60 feet, or about 1/4 the height of SpaceX Falcon 9 rocket. The new Shepard's boosters start returning to Earth much earlier than Falcon 9's boosters. It starts heading back at 100 kilometers in altitude, while the Falcon 9 boosters don't start descent until 200 kilometers in altitude. Also, the Falcon 9 booster is not only much heavier, but it's traveling considerably faster compared to New Shepard. The Blue Origin rocket reaches up to Mach 3 during its flight, while Falcon 9 reaches between Mach 5.5 and Mach 7 before its booster starts a descent. The landing of both rocket boosters is also quite different from each other. So, who will win the space race? Realistically speaking, there is no winning or losing in space, but technology matters. SpaceX has many firsts in its names. For instance, building and sending liquid-fueled rockets into Earth's orbit, developing a small launcher, successfully launching, orbiting, and recovering spacecraft, developing the cheapest rocket, first private company to send humans into space, and more. Blue Origin, on the other hand, likes to take smaller steps at a time. It has so far developed a suborbital capsule system, acquired the technology of reusable rockets with vertical takeoff and landing, made a two-stage orbital launch vehicle with New Glenn, and soon aims to send astronauts to the moon. While SpaceX has sent many rocket designs to orbit and recently sent astronauts to space, Blue Origin is working towards it. It has till now flown suborbital rocket flights and is in the early stages of assembling its first rocket capable of reaching orbit. Though there is visible lag, experts believe that Blue Origin is well set for giving major competition for SpaceX, especially with Amazon's Kuiper project and AWS Space Unit. It can soon be expected to make a competitive move against SpaceX. In the end, it is quite noticeable that SpaceX technologies are far more advanced and so much more in use in 2020, and will be used even more in 2021. But Blue Origin has sort of a different goal compared to SpaceX. That is, O'Neill cylinders versus Mars cities. So comparing these two companies head to head doesn't quite make sense here. Now let us discuss the most efficient space program, Israel. Well, that actually sounds like a different topic to investigate on DiscoverZen.